Hello, I'm Sean Skinner. Welcome to the fourth video in my series of four videos on checking for ice hockey. This video is entitled Contact Confidence and Body Checking. In this video, we will look at five sections on body contact, with each section divided further into chapters. In the first section, I will show drills that develop the proper body contact and increase a player's confidence in hitting and getting hit. Then in the second section, we will learn how to use your body to throw different body blocks, pin checks, shoulder and hip checks. In the third section, I will show how to take and receive a check along the boards and in open ice. And in the fourth section, I will show how to avoid or slip checks. And finally, in the fifth section, we will look at body checking penalties. Before we look at the actual body checks, I'd like to point out the anthropometric and the biomechanical differences between peewee age hockey players and note some concerns about checking within our age categories. The Physical Education Department at the Laval University in Quebec did a study on body checking in peewee hockey in 1986. The results of the study were published in the Physician and Sports Medicine in March of 1989. This study showed the vast differences in height, weight, strength, and force at impact for peewee players in the Quebec hockey leagues. Also, they compared the number of injuries between the checking and non-checking leagues and found that 55% of all injuries were due to body contacts. And serious injuries occurred 6 times more often than in non-checking leagues. In addition, body checking accounted for 88% of the 25 fractures, 15 of which were of the clavicle, and these were all recorded during one hockey season. In 1997, I tested an entire hockey club in Colorado Springs and found one peewee player that skated 10 miles per hour weighing 59 pounds, and another that skated 18 miles per hour and weighed 140 pounds. Now, these players are supposed to compete, battle, and check each other over the course of a game. One has a serious advantage. I've included a picture here to show the difference of two peewee hockey players in Colorado playing in the same league in the 2000-2001 season. One player, 4 feet 10, weighing 79 pounds, and the other, 6 feet, weighing 180 pounds. It's interesting to note that most of the provinces in Canadian hockey have taken body checking out of the peewee level. And in most countries in Europe, body checking does not start until age 13 or 14. USA Hockey is also looking into taking checking out of peewee hockey, where these age differences occur, and size differences. With these differences in mind, let's learn how to give and receive body contact properly so that players do not get injured. Contact confidence drills are a series of drills designed to prepare players for body checking by teaching the proper methods of giving and receiving body contact. These drills follow a progression of bumping from close distances leading up to full contact with hitting from further distances. Players will gain stability and strength on their feet, learning how to handle contact and realizing that even taking a hard check does not have to hurt when taken properly. Players enjoy the challenge and fun of the competitive nature of the drills, and again, increasing their confidence for body checking. The first drill in our contact confidence progression is to bump the boards. And here, the player is developing the beginning parts of the body checking by driving and pushing with the outside leg. The key to checking is this push with the outside leg. So what we're doing is we're working on this push with the outside leg and keeping the body straight up and down. So contact should be made with the outside of the arm and the outside of the shoulder. Not the point of the shoulder like this, but with the side of the shoulder. So you're hitting like this. Done properly, you don't need pads on because you're hitting with the muscle sheet out there. So you're coming in and hitting the boards.
Now we're going to take a look at the absorb the hit drill. This is excellent for beginning contact. What's happening is the players around the circle are stationary and one person's moving, and they're going to move with contact into the other player, keeping the back leg back for support. The opponent has his back leg back for support. It's like a pole vault in the ice. And you're making the shoulder contact. As you make the shoulder contact, you're going to get pushed slightly backwards, and you got to fight through that hit. Now, it's so important that the player has the leg backwards. That's where the check initiates from, this leg. If the player has the feet straight across from their body as the guy comes in to check, he's just going to go flying. So you got to have that back leg back to support you up. It would look like this again.
Body checking involves using the body to block the puck carrier's skating lane, to rub or ride them off along the boards, to hit the opponent directly and knock them off the puck, or to hit and pin the opponent. Now, a good body checker needs exceptional lateral skating agility. And while using this skating agility, they need good or proper body position. This means that the legs need to be spread. When they're farther away, they need a narrow base while out of checking range to increase mobility and to handle quick direction changes. As the player gets closer, they need a wider base for balance, stability, and strength. Also, a good checker needs upper body forward lean, and the weight should be on the inside edge of the outside skate for power and balance. The player also needs to be able to check while skating forwards and backwards.
The purpose of body checking is not to slam your opponent into the wall as hard as you can or hurt the opponent. Too often we see players coming down the ice and the player slams them into the wall. They both bounce off and he still skates in and makes a pass or takes a shot and scores.
The purpose of body checking is to block the progress of the puck carrier towards your net by getting in the skating path, or to gain puck possession by knocking the opponent off the puck, or to gain puck possession by separating the puck carrier from the puck by pinning. Finishing a check is also referred to as completing a check or following through on a check. According to the rules, you're only allowed to hit a player that has puck possession. Finishing a check is to hit another player in the act of passing or shooting. Now, many players will turn away early when the opponent may be just faking a shot or a pass. Usually, players should always finish their checks unless the style of play for that particular game or period is such that you want to conserve energy and strength. Hitting and sticking an opponent is taking finishing a check one step further. This is a preventative method to stop a give-and-go situation. Sometimes hitting and sticking is referred to as pinning or locking onto your coverage. Sticks and elbows down. Players should be taught to keep their sticks and elbows down. Keeping the sticks and elbows up can lead to penalties, and players should use their shoulders and hips instead. Arms and sticks. Very often, when players are learning to check, they try to reach out with their arms or their stick. When checking, the defensive player should not have to reach out with their arms, but rather move their body in front of the opponent to make a check. Body checking is a coiled reaction from the legs, not a pushing motion with the arms. Likewise, instead of reaching out with the stick and hooking, the player should move their feet and skate faster. Straight on checking is very difficult and is usually done when the opponent's head is down. Instead of checking straight on, the player should angle or steer the opponent towards the boards. Timing and skating speed. Timing and skating speed is what makes body checking one of the hardest skills to teach. Most of the checking situations involve hitting a moving target. What usually happens when players are learning to check is that they know and understand the technical aspects to the check, but they are not successful because their timing is off. Players need to match the speed of the opposing player and attempt to check within one stick length. Do not lunge or reach at the opponent. Body blocks or blocking checks are usually used in non-checking levels or leagues. Using a blocking check involves getting in front of the puck carrier and stopping or slowing their progress towards the net. This can be done while skating backwards or forwards. Picks and screens are used more in the European style of the game. It takes a very well-coached team to be able to use picks and screens, because they're usually done in pre-planned areas. Also, picks and screens are an advanced way to support the puck carrier. The danger with running picks and screens is that you may get called for interference depending on how the player executes the pick or screen. To avoid the interference penalty, pick or screen while standing sideways or with your back facing the opponent. If you pick facing the opponent, you can get an interference penalty. A pick is usually done on the power play. It is executed when the supporting offensive player skates over to an opponent who is covering the puck carrier. This supporting player ties up the opponent so that the puck carrier is free to move around the opponent. A screen is executed by skating in front of the opponent with no physical contact, or skating in front of the goalie to block the view of the puck.
When the puck carrier tries to drive to the net, the puck carrier and the defensive opponent are trying to fight for shoulder space. So as he's coming in, he's trying to get his shoulder slightly in front of mine so he can beat me to the net. Or the defensive player is trying to get their shoulder slightly in front of the opponent's so they can force him wide away from the net. Now we're going to take a look at the roll check. The roll check is done when approaching the puck carrier from behind or besides. The important thing here is that the player keeps their legs moving. In actuality, the player really wants to overtake the opponent by skating. But there's a four-step process here that we're looking at. The player's approaching from behind. We're going to do this in slow motion. The player would like to lift the stick if possible, but because he's right-handed on me, I don't have that option on this side. My first technique from this side then is going to be to push on this elbow. So I take my hand and I push on this elbow, which starts to rotate his shoulders around. I'm trying to do a roll check. So after I push on this elbow, I've got an imaginary X on the back of his shoulder, and I drive my shoulder into his shoulder, rolling his body around into the wall. Okay, again, coming up from behind, I push down and out on that elbow, and I drive my shoulder into the wall. Now I've got an option here from this position to, depending on where the puck goes, the puck's in between his legs, I could go and slide my leg in between his for a pin check. If the puck were to roll out in front of him as I make this check, if I were to roll him in and the puck's out in front, I can take this inside leg and bring it in front of the body and skate off with the puck. Now doing this check from the other side, because he's right-handed and his stick falls out to the middle, that gives me the option to come in and do a lift check first. And then, as his shoulder's turned, I've got my imaginary X on his shoulder. I drive that shoulder, rolling his body into the wall, and I can come out with the puck again. Our next check is called the rub out, write off, or take out of the play. Now here, this check is very similar to the roll check in that you can do this player as the defensive player is coming from behind the puck carrier or from the side. Now what happens on this play, instead of rolling the player's shoulder like the roll check in the takeout, again, you want to really overtake the puck carrier with skating speed, and you're trying to skate through the player's gloves and stick, trying to come right in front. And as you're skating up and you do that, you try to come in front and you put your lower body behind. So you want your upper body in front and your lower body behind. As we're moving up the ice here, you kind of squeeze them in and you rub them out or take them out of the play. From the other side, same thing, I'm coming up and I try to skate right through. I've got my upper body in front and the lower body behind. You're squeezing the opponent in here. The next check is called a pin check, and it's next in our progression because usually a roll check or a rub out leads to this pin check. But what happens here is as we come in and we execute either a roll check or a rub out, we've positioned the player's body in towards the boards, and we take our back leg here and we drive that back leg into between the opponent's skates. We need to drive that knee all the way into the boards so he can't get out. Common mistake here is that as the players drive that in, they take the elbow and they get the elbow up here for elbowing. Okay, the elbow has to be kept down. We press the shoulder right into the back and you push on the player's hips right here with your bottom hand so they lose all control and they're squished against the board. This back skate is parallel to the boards and that's your pushing leg to drive and keep the opponent there. The opponent tries to get away. You've got about 2 or 3 seconds to hold them. Go ahead. Okay. The wrap check is our next check, and it's the best form of pinning the opponent because if done properly, the opponent cannot get out. Let's go back to our pin check from before. If I show the pin check where I come in and I drive my leg in between the opponent's knee skates, he can always step out. Lift up his leg and he could step out. There's a way to escape. He can push off the wall and get out. But in the pin check, with the wrap check, pinning the opponent, they can't get out. Now, there's two ways to do this wrap check. I'm a left-handed player coming from behind here on his right side. And holding the stick in the top hand, you slide the stick in between the boards and the opponent's body. Okay? I take my top hand, and I'm going to place it on the opponent's back with the palm open. Okay, so the top hand comes in, and the bottom hand's on his back. If he tries to go forward, he can't, even with the, go ahead real hard, even with the lightest amount of resistance, I don't have to do much work. He can't get by the stick. If he tries to come backwards, I've got my hand on his back. I can hold him for a couple of seconds. I can let him move forward a little bit. I can wrap him again. Okay? From the other side, it's a little different now because I hold the stick in the top hand. The stick has to come from behind the opponent, and the top hand gets up again with the palm open, and the body has to come around with this hand in his chest. So if he tries to go forward, he can't because I'm in his way. If he tries to spin out and go backwards, he can't because the stick's got him locked in on the wall. It's a wrap check. Now we're going to take a look at the shoulder check. The shoulder check is done by a defenseman that's taking out the puck carrier, the attacking puck carrier. Now timing is very important on this technique, and the defenseman doesn't want to watch the puck. Very important to watch the opponent's body. So it would look something like this. As the approaching forwards attacking, the defenseman's trying to funnel the attacking player in. When the player gets almost to the side of them, they can use a crossover step. They can't do it too early or their forward will cut back. So when you've got them almost on the side, a crossover step to drive and push with that back leg and drive your shoulder into the opponent's chest right in front and your inside leg all the way into the wall. So that just in case you don't hit him in front with your shoulder, he still doesn't squeeze by you. You've got your knee all the way into the wall. So again, just showing the check right here. As the opponent's coming in, you're backing up a crossover step. Drive your shoulder right into theirs. Now I want to show the two different options of finishing on this shoulder check here. We can make a crossover step or just a turn into the shoulder check. When a defensive player has funneled the offensive opponent in and the offensive opponent is three quarters or almost to the side, they don't have any more options to cut back, we can use a crossover step to finish with the shoulder check. Okay? Generally, when you're playing out away from the boards, you don't want to use a crossover step because if you cross over too soon, the player can cut back to the middle. It's when the player is almost on the side of you. If the player is out in front, then you just want to make a turn so that you can still react and then come up and take your shoulder check. Thank you. Now we're going to take a look at the hip check. The hip check is the most difficult of all body checks to execute, especially in open ice. We're going to take a look at this first along the boards. What happens is a defenseman that's playing the attacking puck carrier may choose to use a hip check instead of the shoulder check. Now, the puck carrier wants to try to slip by. The defenseman has to wait till the puck carrier is almost right next to him on the side, and he's going to use a crossover step and a C-cut push with the outside leg with this weight on the inside leg. As the player's body comes in and hits the opponent, the defenseman's going to push up with his legs, forcing the player to flip over the top. Now, just like the shoulder check, I want to show the options on the hip check for finishing. There's two options, a crossover and just a C-cut. The crossover is usually used in open ice and along the boards. Sometimes the C-cut's used. So what we're talking about here is, as you funnel the player in, you take a crossover step to get into this hip check position. All right? Or the player can use just a straight C-cut as he's really close and he's coming in. He can C-cut and turn and plant for that hip check.
Taking and receiving checks. This section will help players become more comfortable with body checking. Oftentimes, the puck carrier will get hit while they have the puck or just after they have made a play. A player should expect to get hit. It is a part of fair play. Players should never give up the puck or not complete a play because they are afraid of being hit. There are situations where a player may have to take a check for the betterment of the team. Players can learn how to reduce or avoid hard hits while completing plays. Also, players can develop courage from body checking. Courage is defined as doing something even when you know the outcome may not be good. To reduce the chance of concussions, players should wear mouth guards and proper fitting helmets. Here I am featuring this very unique mouth guard by Whips. This mouthguard is very unique because it has a built-in hole for breathing. Whips refers to this mouthguard as more of a brain pad. For more information on this product, call 888-424-WHIPS or visit their website at www.brain-pad.com. Players should use the following techniques to take and receive body checks.
Now, when taking or receiving a check, the player wants to use skill and technique in order to receive the check. And we do this by getting a wide base, spreading out your feet, especially along the boards, making your center of gravity low by bending your knees. And as we receive this check, we don't want to stand out here about 3 to 5 feet away from the wall. If I stand out here about 3 to 5 feet away from the wall and I try to hit back at the opponent and I lose the battle and I get sent into the wall from there, it's a great way to break a collarbone or get a broken neck. There's a danger zone in this 3 to 5 feet space. Okay, I don't want to end up taking that check with the point of the shoulder going into the wall. So when I get into this wide base and I see the check coming along the ball, along the boards, I receive by making my body fat, and I cushion just like you would take a pass. I cushion by putting the forearm out on this side, and then putting the forearm out on this side. As the player comes in, I let him squeeze and push me into the glass. And at this point, there's a natural rebound effect that after I'm just totally squished, you can push right back out. Okay? So again, you're making your body fat. The last thing is to take this inside leg as the check's coming and thrust it forward as you're getting pushed so that now you can push back and continue to skate through this check. Depending on the type of check along the boards, you want to use your arms and hands to brace yourself. If we're coming into the boards and I have the puck and I'm getting hit from behind, I want to put my arms up here to brace myself on the wall and then try to fight for the puck after I take the hit. But from this position, I can use my arms as kind of a shock absorber. So as he hits me, I can come in and push off. If a player is going into the boards head first, go in with your head up, don't duck.
When going into the corner or the boards, a player can avoid being checked from behind by angling in or turning sideways before impact.
In order to avoid checking from behind, when coming into the boards, very close to the boards, within 5-10 feet, and with a forechecker right on your back, you want to turn your body sideways. It's the key to avoid checking from behind anytime we're coming into the corner. So if the puck has gone in and you're flying in with someone right on you that's going to nail you, just turn sideways. This is so important. A lot of players will try to come in and they'll worry about playing the puck first. As they come in, they'll try to set the puck and they can get the stick jammed in here, trying to turn it. Don't worry about the puck. Worry about turning your body sideways so that you live to play hockey another day. Okay, step up. Play it after the puck goes in. Get right behind him. Step up to the line. Okay, Johnny, come on up. Okay, now I'd like to make one comment as you see the players doing this drill. Very common for a player to come in on their forehand side. When Johnny comes in here on his forehand side, his body twists around his upper body, but he still has turned his lower body sideways. And players can still take the impact like this and still get checked from behind or checked in an awkward position. It's very important that when the player comes in and turns his body sideways, especially on the forehand side, that he lets go with this bottom hand and bends his arm right here in tight so his shoulders are sideways, and then he takes the impact right from the side. Hip pointers are very common when receiving checks. Players get hip pointers when being checked into the boards right on the lip. The boards has a little edge here, and when getting checked from the side, the player can get checked right with their hip against this. Players want to make sure that their body is either below the board line or above the board line so they don't get a hip pointer on the side. When to take a check. First, we're going to look at taking a hit to make a pass. Usually on a breakout situation, the winger is receiving a pass from the defenseman and wants to forward that pass onto the center while a pinching defenseman is coming in and hitting. What the winger wants to do is, as they forward the puck on and the pinching defenseman comes in, is brace themselves against the wall so that they can take this check. Would look something like this. If the defenseman comes in from an angle and isn't coming straight down the side, And not only do they want to brace themselves, but they want to get their stick up to protect themselves on this hit. So that would look something like this. Now we're going to take a look at taking a hit to maintain puck possession. When we talk in puck possession, the first thing we want to do as we're coming up to the opponent is protect the puck with our body. If I leave the puck out in front, his first check would be a stick check and just poke the puck out. So what I do is I move the puck to the side, so I'm protecting the puck with my body. Now my body is between the puck and him. That forces him to make body contact. If he's still trying to reach in with the stick, I can use my leg or my body to protect the puck. I could also use my glove in a manner, if I was driving around the opponent, in glove protection here, where he's trying to reach in and I'm beating him away from the puck. Lastly is that I can fully turn my body. So at first I move the puck and now I turn my body and I use my butt to protect the puck. Anytime he's coming around, I keep my butt towards the opponent. We're gonna do this now in a drill. Now here's a puck protection drill that a couple players can do. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to keep your butt facing the opponent the whole time. So as the opponent comes around to the side, you're gonna move your butt in front of the opponent. Now, problem on this is that players don't have the movement technique. The movement is to open up your hips in a V and come around. If they move just a little bit, you move to the side a little bit, keep your butt in front of the opponent. If they move real fast and come around, you may have to come real far around and get your butt in front of them to protect this puck or protect the dot. Also, too often is that players look over this shoulder and then this shoulder and this shoulder and lose the guy. Play from your forehand side like this. Always look over this shoulder so you can see him. If he goes to the side, you got him. Okay, so here's gonna be the drill. Start off with light competition first, where the opponent is just going to side to side so that you get the movement pattern, and then go to more competition. Would look like this. Good. maintaining puck possession against the wall, you want to brace yourself using your hands and your arms. So as the player comes in, you want to maintain puck possession. You use your feet to keep puck possession, and at the same time you're using your feet, you're bracing yourself with your arms and your stick.
Avoiding the intimidation game. After getting hit, players should try to get up fast, jump back into the play as quick as possible, skate to the bench as fast as they can, jump back over the boards as quick as possible. Suck it up, don't retaliate. Try not to show pain.
Grab me a tie now, why don't you throw a real check, huh? Oh, coach, I think I broke my arm.
Which one, this one? Yeah.
Players can avoid checks by trying not to get hit. Avoid hits by keeping your head up and your eyes scanning the play. Avoid looking back or reaching back for a pass by cutting laterally. Against the boards, players can slip checks by faking. Also, players can slip checks by moving low or kneeling down, by dropping or bending down to slip under, because most checkers come up high as they hit. Also, players can slip checks by moving ahead or jumping past or changing the pace. Players can slip checks by moving behind or stopping. And players can slip checks by rolling out of a check.
Now we're going to take a look at rolling out of a check. It's another way to avoid a hit or escape the hit. What happens is this check is used, this rolling out of a check is used as you're along the boards. I already know that he wants to roll my shoulder in, so I give him that shoulder. As he rolls my shoulder all the way into the wall, I push off the wall, roll off his back, and then come on out with the puck. Same thing from this other side here. This is a little trickier though. I'm on my forehand, but I've got to turn my stick in on the backhand. So as I'm coming into the wall, I push the puck out in front of my body, turn my hands in, I let him take me all the way into the wall, and I push off the wall and go around his back. Hopefully the puck's out. If it's not, I've rolled around him, I've avoided the check. The key thing here is that it's a skating move, and you're just rolling. You're not doing a stop and a spin. If the player comes in and stops like this, you can get checked. You can almost get your head checked into the boards. Okay, you don't want to stop. You want to let them take you all the way into the wall. And if we looked at it just from the skating mechanics, as the puck's going out, you're skating, turn, and going forward.
Players can slip checks in the open ice by moving laterally with or without a fake. They can also slip checks in open ice with an escape or a spin move. And finally, players can slip checks in open ice by using a delay or a stop.
In this section, we're going to take a look at avoiding screens and picks. We commonly see this situation happening in hockey, where a defensive player is playing the puck carrier against the sidewall here, and another player comes up and lays a pick from the side. You can roll off the player in order to stop the puck. You roll or spin off the player. If the opponent is coming from the front, say a defensive player is coming down to skate in front and pick the player, usually they'll pick the player by putting the stick in between the legs. What the player wants to do on this type of situation, because once the stick gets between the legs, the player's locked up and they can't cross over, they can't move, is to block the stick. So he's playing, an opponent comes in, and you got to block the stick and then play the opponent. The last way to avoid screens and picks is switching coverage with your teammate. When two offensive players are crossing, trying to switch coverage, the two defensive players can stop in the middle and switch coverage with their teammates. If they do it again, they're coming in on a cycle, they stop in the middle, they go back and they switch their coverage.
Now we're going to look at the specific body checking penalties, and I'd like to focus on two programs concerning body checking and penalties. The first is the Milk Energy Penalty-Free Sweepstakes, developed by the HDCO, or the Hockey Development Center of Ontario. This contest challenges teams to play an entire game of hockey without a penalty, thus qualifying to win hockey prizes. In the past 13 years, over 61,700 entries have been received, and 63% of these teams have won or tied their penalty-free game, indicating that playing clean hockey leads to winning. For more information on this program, call 888-THE-HDCO or visit their website at www.hdco.on.ca. The second program that I'd like to focus on is the STOP program, which stands for Safety Towards Other Players. This program was designed to reduce checking from behind. The Ontario Minor Hockey Association has developed this worldwide program to discourage this checking from behind. Players participate in this program by wearing stop signs on the backs of their jerseys. For more information about this program, call 905-780-6642 or visit their website at www.omha.net. Checking from behind. Any deliberate check to an opponent from behind, regardless of degree of force, shall be penalized.
Green, checking from behind.
A check delivered directly or diagonally from behind.
Green, checking from behind.
A push from behind causes a player to go head first into the boards or the goal frame.
Green, checking from behind.
The opponent is turned away from the player, so is unable to see the check coming.
Green, checking from behind. White, checking from behind.
Charging. When the player takes two or more strides prior to hitting the opponent. When the player uses excessive force when checking the player. When the player makes no attempt to play the puck.
White, charging.
Boarding. When the player being checked is thrown violently into the boards. The player being checked is usually stationary or slow moving.
Green, boarding.
Interference. When a defensive player makes bodily contact with an opposing player who is not in possession of the puck.
White, interference. White, interference.
Offensive interference is when a teammate runs interference for the puck carrier by forming a protective screen against the forecheckers. holding. The player's action by use of hands or stick in any other way impedes the opponent.
Let him go. Let him go. Let him go. Green, hold.
The player grabs the opponent's stick, causing the player to be unable to successfully play the puck.
White, hold.
Elbowing. Any contact to the head of the opponent with the elbow shall be penalized.
Green, elbow.
Any deliberate contact to the body by extending or thrusting it at an opponent shall be penalized.
White, elbowing.
Roughing. The action was performed in an effort to incite or intimidate an opponent. Roughing does not have to be confined to punching actions. In no check age classifications, roughing is called when a player deliberately checks an opponent. When the player delivers an avoidable body check after the whistle, or to a player who is no longer in possession and control of the puck.
Green, roughing.
When contact is made with the gloves to the head area of the opponent.
Let's go. Cut it out, both feet. Both of you in the box, roughing.